We Facebook friend our family members, our classmates, coworkers, even some neighbors. But what about your doctor? Dr. Noelle LeConte, an oncologist from the UW-Carbone Cancer Center, she is back with us this afternoon with some insights. All right, this is a conversation gaining in momentum. You Google this topic, and there's a lot of chatter out there about this right now. What's your initial take on it?
My initial take is fairly black and white, that patients and doctors have such an inherently unbalanced relationship. There's such a, not power differential, but there's, the doctor's always in this position that they have things that the patient may need, that it's not, you can't really be friends. And, you know, Facebook is really informal. You share things like vacation photos and other personal things that I wouldn't necessarily always want my patients to know about, your address, your date of birth, that I don't think it's a good policy.
Yeah. There's a lot more access, though, to doctors, a lot of, and actually I stumbled across an ad today, and I was thinking about this interview coming up, where one of the area health groups, there it is right there, is GHC, you know, it's really encouraging their patients to email their doctors. And that's a totally different story, you're saying?
Totally different. I mean, I give all my patients and their families my email address.
Is that the best way to reach you? And how is that evolving? Because
not everybody does it. I mean, it's still sort of provider choice. I think the majority of us don't. But I feel like as a cancer doctor, if I can alleviate some anxiety by giving them one more way to contact me on the weekends or after hours, as long as it's not a medical emergency, then I'm happy to do that. Because I can control the email. I can know when I'm logging on and when I'm logging off.
When you have to, and actually, you've gotten off Facebook.
I did.
Because of this issue?
Because of this and some other privacy issues. But I just felt uncomfortable denying friend requests from patients and families. Not that I don't care deeply about my patients. Of course I do. But it just became to a point where, you know, I have a very, maybe not as much as you, but I have a job where a lot of people know me. It's a fairly public job, and I didn't feel like I could share all the things I wanted to share with my real life friends on Facebook. So
yeah, I'm struggling with that same dilemma.
Yeah.
It had been personal, and anyway, that's a whole other scenario.
Right.
But so etiquette for patients that maybe want to have more of a relationship with their doc. Is there anything that you would advise them to do?
I think you can ask the provider if it's okay to email. I mean, a lot of, especially at the UW, a lot of our email is publicly available. You know, just a good Google searcher can turn that up. You know, always asking the provider if they don't explicitly say if it's okay to email.
Just respect each other's privacy, because you need to do the same with the patient's information.
Correct. Right.
Absolutely. All right, Noelle LeConte, great to see you again.
Likewise.
Thanks so much for coming
in. No problem.